Life on a reality show can be grueling, exhilarating, filled with intrigue, betrayal, and fantasies of revenge. But what happens to those contestants when their tiki torches have gone out, when the camera crews are gone, and they're finally permitted to shower? When they're sequestered by producers in an undisclosed location, while the rest of their teammates have a bonfire without them? Before they're forced to return to a life of obscurity, when they've brushed their teeth for over 12 million viewers, how do they go back to doing it for just one? What happens when their carefully orchestrated plans for vengeance result in a criminal record, 6 months probation, and land them in court-ordered therapy? And what happens when they're convinced that it's all being caught on camera? What happens is this. Donna's Revenge, Confessions of an Ex-Contestant.
Hello. Welcome to Donna's Revenge, Confessions of an Ex-Contestant. I'm Donna Wicklins, the closest, most almost winner on So You Think This Is Your Islands. And I'm here to talk about the dark underbelly of life on a reality show and why I should have won. Joining me is my life coach, Dr. Wang Lang. Well, I guess technically he's my therapist, you know, court ordered and whatever, but I like to think of him as a life coach, a partner on this journey of self-discovery and growth. You know, well, I've got a pro meeting every Thursday and an ankle bracelet. So, my life coach, Dr. Wang Lang, suggested I pick three goals for the new me in the new year, the year of the ox, which is like a goat, only bigger and without the beard.
Let's talk about choices, Donna. It's a new year, a fresh start, chance to better your life. How does that make you feel?
Like kicking a stranger. Just kidding.
Are you?
Maybe.
I've got a goal for you. How about learning to love yourself?
No, I think what I want is to get a boyfriend, you know? Someone will say, you're hot, you know?
You'd like love in your life. That's understandable. I think most of us...
And maybe a job, you know? Or maybe what I should do really is get back into work with people. Because most of my friends are like, you're so outgoing, you're so personable. You should do like something with the media or whatever. Like show people what life is like through your eyes. Especially since that was definitely one of my assets on So You Think This Is Your Islands. My ability to communicate with people.
So it's alright then, you can all eat f***ing burgers and I have to eat two dead f***ing fish. Well f*** you, f***ing your stupid f***ing burgers, f***ing stupid f***.
And I do have a lot of experience, both with cameras and with cameramen.
How about something less public? Something more for you, not for the outside world.
Right, like maybe like a talk show. Like, why are you carrying his baby? Is it the drugs? You know, I really pry into people's lives, ask the tough questions.
Interesting. Do you wish someone would ask you those questions?
And, you know, I have done some work with, I am very good with kids. You know, I did do some work as a birthday clown for a very short period of time and was very successful at it. I come in, do a little dance, you know, because I really like to dance. And then I like to play this game that I used to play in grade school called Break You Down to Build You Up. It's sort of a self-improvement game for little people. Your ankles are like sausages. You were terrible at tag. You've absolutely no coordination. And you need to learn to use the potty. I did find that some people were not ready to hear what I had to say, but pink is a very good color on you.
What did you learn from that experience?
That children are pussies. What I need is a job I can really sink my teeth into. Something that plays to my strengths, you know?
Are you concerned about how your criminal history might affect that?
How do you mean?
Well, some people might be reluctant to...
No, I don't think people want to know a little bit about you. I think an element of mystery is good, you know? I bet people find that alluring. Can we trust her? Can we not trust her? Would she lock you out of the house without your clothes on, videotape it, and put it on the internet? Quite possibly, yes. Who's to say? It's very important to keep your audience guessing.
Donna, could we How would you feel about turning off the cameras for a moment?
No, sorry, no, can't do that. It's very important for me to record all of my journey, the good and the bad. I have a duty to my audience to be truthful in that way.
And do you have one, an audience?
Obviously I do, yeah.
Real or imagined?
What do you think?
Well, I'd like to know what you think.
Well, I'm not telling, am I?
Why not?
Wouldn't you like to know?
I sing in the shower.
Do you?
I yell at my car, I talk to the radio, and sometimes it feels like they almost talk back. How about a goal for the inner you?
What do you mean? Like a colonic?
No, not
I think whatever's in there should probably stay in there, you know what I mean?
For the spiritual you.
Do you mean like church or whatever?
Whatever spirituality means to you, religion, connecting to something bigger than yourself.
Like a planet.
Something to help you find an increased sense of spiritual calm.
Oh, right. Okay, so I'll work on that too.
Good. So these goals, Donna.
I've got three of them now. Is that too many?
No, I think...
Is three too many? Can I do it?
I think the most important thing...
Someone's going home tomorrow and it's not going to be me.
...is for you to let go of the need to pursue these goals in public. They're for you, not for... anyone else you think might be watching.
Are you trying to intimidate me, Dr. Wengling?
No.
Throw me off my game?
What do you think?
I think you are. I think there's a very, very good chance that I'll be voted back onto the island, and that worries you.
And why would that worry me?
It's not like you'd be paid by the state if I'm on a TV show.
Well, Donna,
if I'm a TV star.
I think that you should let go of that experience. I think that's part of the healing process.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
Life is not a reality show, Donna.
Oh, right, I've heard that one before.
It's your life. No one is watching.
Tell that to 13 million viewers.
So I think when you let go of this need for public validation...
Tune in next week as I, Donna Whitley, the Columbus World
Will disappear.
Bogey Peace is your island. Find love, employment,
well, that's all the time
increased
we have,
spirituality,
in the meantime,
and revenge.
Donna.
Kidding.
In the meantime...
All while counting to 10, using
your
my anger pillow and staying completely
stay
out of prison on the second installment of Donna's Revenge. Confessions of an Ex-Contestant.